Adapting to recent changes in our global workflow has made remote employee training more relevant than ever. Today, we're going to look at some tips and tricks to help you with your remote employee training. The first step to starting your online training course is to choose a delivery model. You can use the synchronous learning model, where all the learners are participating simultaneously. The asynchronous learning model is another option, which is self-paced. The learners can access and move through the course in their own time. Finally, the blended learning model takes elements of both. Because of its flexibility, a blended course may be the best way to approach more complex remote training requirements. Next, you need to make sure that you have the necessary tools to create and deliver your content. At a minimum, you'll need a conferencing webinar platform in order to make wide-scale, video-enabled training work. You can either use a standalone web conferencing tool for this or a more robust virtual training platform. How will you manage to deploy and track your training efforts? This is where a learning management system comes in. A good LMS will take the hard work out of inviting attendees for remote sessions, among other things. A good example of cloud-based LMS is iSpring Learn. It offers a wide array of functionality that makes it simple to build and deliver remote training programs. Finally, you'll need an e-learning authoring tool. You should look out for authoring tools that are HTML5 based, are easy to use, and support a variety of output formats. By the way, iSpring Learn LMS has full integration with the iSpring Suite authoring toolkit. So if you want to build more complex, interactive courses, dialogue simulations, quizzes, and video tutorials, you'll find the whole ecosystem that's extremely well integrated. This remote training strategy only works when your learning content adjusts to different screen sizes and browsers. iSpring creates mobile-ready courses that adapt to any screen size. Okay, now it's time to prepare your learning materials. Most e-learning authoring tools will allow you to choose a template and then build out content using sections or blocks to get a course up and running rather quickly. iSpring Suite, for example, has a vast content library of course templates featuring standard elements like title slides, tables of contents, and navigation, chapters, timelines, and info slides. Once you have the base of your course built, you can start adding some interactive elements like videos, surveys, and assessments. When your course is finished, it's time to deliver your training. The good news is that because you're using an LMS, this should be simple to set up. If you decide on an asynchronous approach with e-learning, it should be as simple as sending out invites for your course and deciding on how you want to track completions. For synchronous efforts, you may need to also consider exactly how you'll deliver the training over a virtual classroom format. iSpring Learn allows you to connect with Zoom to host your webinars right from the platform. Lastly, once your course is set up and running, you'll need to make sure you can track your learners' results. Your LMS should have you covered here. iSpring Learn, for example, has easy to access but very detailed learning tracking. That wraps up this deep dive into remote employee training. We've covered a lot of material on this very current topic, and we hope you found some useful information that will help you improve your remote sessions.